गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
सोशल साइंस पीरियोडिक टेस्ट ऑन कमिंग सैटरडे. लेट ऑल ऑफ यू गो टाइम टेबल. टू लेसन्स विल बी देयर, वन फ्रॉम हिस्ट्री एंड वन फ्रॉम ज्योग्राफी. यू नो दैट राइट? ऑल ऑफ यू नो अबाउट दिस.
यस मैम.
देन टुडे आई वांट टू रिवाइज हिस्ट्री फर्स्ट लेसन. शैल वी रिवाइज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर?
यस यस मैम.
Underline all the important points. I think you might have learned all the question answers from one word questions from your textbook, right? Read yes. your textbook, read textbook and be thorough with it. Then only you can answer all the question answers. Okay. Under the heading, where did people live? People, those who lived on the banks. Okay, wait, I'll be waiting for more participants. Only few join, tell us. 2-3 minutes, I can wait for them. 2 more minutes, we can wait for all the children. Take your history textbook by the time. All of you.
Yeah, ma'am.
Take your history textbook. Turn on your video.
Ma'am, we have to take history textbook.
Yes, history
textbook. Ma'am, I didn't get the textbook.
Ma'am, I didn't get the textbook.
How will you prepare for your class? Do you have
the textbook?
You can download it from Google.
Okay, ma'am.
The form is available. Today it's a download. It's available. Shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
People, those who lived on the banks of Narmada, River Narmada, where? Who they were?
Gatherers and
hunters.
They were skill gatherers, right? They were skill gatherers. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
People, those who lived on the banks of river, underlined all those points when I discussed. People, those who lived on the banks of River Narmada were skill gatherers and hunters. Underline, skill gatherers and hunters. They gather. What is the meaning of gathering? Collecting food, right? Early people, those who lived on the banks of River Narmada, they collected food from forest. They collected roots, fruits and other forest produce for their food. Clear? Some people lived in Sulaiman and Kirtar Hills. People, men and women, those who lived in Sulaiman and Kirtar Hill, they began to grow crops such as
wheat and barley.
Very good. Wheat and barley. And they began rearing sheep, goat and cattle, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Third group of people, they live in Garo Hills. Francis Richard. Be attentive in the class, dear. We are revising for our exam. So be attentive in the class. Then, people, those who live in Garo Hills and to the northwest, northeast of India, in central India, they developed agriculture, right? Then,
yes,
rice, the place where rice was first grown to the north of Vindhya, underline. Rice was first grown to the north of Vindhya.
Where was the slow?
Ashish Unni.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you hear me?
Ma'am, your voice is very low.
My voice is very low. Is it right?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, sorry.
My voice is very low.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
No.
I think you click the
check your network sound. Okay. Then rice was first grown to the north of
Vindhya.
North
India.
Of?
India.
Yours. India.
Then, next is, what is tributary? Small river flow into large rivers.
Large river.
Tributary, known as tributary, right? Small rivers flow into large
rivers.
Ganga. What is the tribute? What is the name of Ganga's tributary?
Ma'am, which textbook?
Yes.
Which textbook?
Ma'am, Yamuna. Ma'am, river in this?
Dash is a tributary of river Ganga.
In the
sun.
And sun.
And the lime. Yeah, Smriti, good. Sun. Pink color. It's written in pink color.
Hello?
Ashish, what are you doing there? Ashish, what are you doing there?
I'm my brother only.
Yeah, your brother only. I'll mute you. Very happy today. What happened? Today you are very happy. What's the reason? Be happy always, but now you attend the class. Who is disturbing you, Ashish? Who is disturbing you?
Brother.
Should I inform this? Underline. Ganga is a tributary of, sorry, sun is a tributary of river Ganga.
Ganga. Yes, ma'am.
Dash is a tributary of river Ganga.
Sun
is a tributary of river. Ganga. Then, in ancient times, the area along these rivers to the south of Ganga was known as Magadha.
Magadha.
In ancient times, the area to the south of Ganga was known as the south Magadha. Of river Ganga was known as
Magadha.
Chudra, what is the answer? Area to the south of river Ganga was known as
Magadha.
Magadha. What's the name of Ganga's tributary?
Sun.
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 Okay. It's easy to remember the name. Sun, right? Sun.
Yes, ma'am.
Spelling is also S-O-N, right? Sun. Yes. Boys will never forget the tributary of river Ganga. Then, you know why did people travel from one place to another, right? Because of many reasons people travel from one place to another, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Food, inside of livelihood, to escape from animals, to escape from natural
disasters. Floods and droughts.
Yes.
Natural disaster.
Yes, natural disaster. The religious leaders traveled and on the way they advised the people. Some people travel by spirit of adventure. Yes, you know it, right? Are you thorough with the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Till this, what we discuss under the heading where people, those who live on the banks of river Narmada, were skill gatherers and hunters.
Yes.
Right? Then people,
yes,
then rice was first grown to the north of Vindhya.
India.
People who lived on Garo Hill and on Garo Sulaiman and Sita Hill, they began growing crops such as
wheat and barley.
Wheat and barley.
They engaged in rearing animals such as sheep and goat. Right?
Yes,
ma'am.
Tributary. Small rivers flow into large rivers.
It's known as
tributary of river Ganga.
Sun.
Then the place or area to the south of river Ganga was called
Magadha.
Then next, name of the land. The word India comes from
Indus.
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 River Indus.
Indus.
India comes from Indus.
Indus.
Called in Sanskrit. The River Indus is called Sindhu in
Sanskrit.
But the word India comes from
Indus.
Indus.
Indus. Indus.
Not from Sindhu, Indus. Okay, but the same word is known as Sindhu in Sanskrit. But the word
Sindhu
comes from the word India comes from Indus.
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 Here are Ashish.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Good. Who is Sri Rudra? Turn on your video. Then, what is the meaning of manuscripts? Yes.
Manuscripts. It's written by on a palm.
What is the meaning of the word manuscripts?
Handwritten by a palm.
Manuscripts.
Written by a palm leaf.
Francis, what are manuscripts?
Yes, ma'am.
What are manuscripts?
Manuscripts are handwritten scripts.
Yes. Where it was written?
On the rock and the on the no the wood. Mas.
And can I say?
Yes.
It's really one that a palm leaf.
Sorry. Richard, Francis Richard.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't be hurry. Kipping can't answer my question. What are manuscripts?
Manuscripts are handwritten.
Yeah, what's the meaning of the word? Manuscript means written by hand. Then work was written.
It's written on palm leaf.
It was written on
and palm leaf. On birch trees. Wood.
Or on the bark of birch tree. Bark means what is the meaning of bark?
Skin
of trees.
Trunk.
Layer of birch tree. Birch is the name of tree that grown in Himalayas, right? So,
yes, ma'am.
Manuscripts were written on palm leaves or on the bark on the of birch tree. Yeah, Richard. Not Richard.
Yes, ma'am.
Richard.
Problem.
Then. Writing on hard surfaces is called what? Artist.
Yes, ma'am.
Writing on hard surfaces.
It's what? Inscription.
Inscription. Who do you know about inscription, Smriti?
Inscriptions are written on hard surfaces like rock or pillars.
Rocks and?
Pillars,
metals. Okay. Then, manuscripts were written in three languages, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Brisha.
Ma'am, Sanskrit, Tamil.
And one more is it? It is important.
Prakrit.
Prakrit. In Sanskrit, Prakrit and Tamil. Then, among this, which was the language of ordinary people?
Ma'am.
Prakrit was the language of common people. It was written in the textbook.
Yes, ma'am.
Sri Rudra, sit up straight.
Yes, ma'am.
Then, language of ordinary people. Dash was the language of ordinary people. Sridhara, answer my question.
Ma'am, Sanskrit.
I was talking about Sanskrit.
No, ma'am.
Then, are you listening to the class? What are you doing there? Tell me. Dash was the language of ordinary people. Ameya.
Yes, ma'am.
Prakrit. 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 Sridhara, repeat the same.
Prakrit.
Prakrit was the underline the sentence Prakrit. In the textbook. Prakrit. Okay. Prakrit is written language used by ordinary people, ordinary right? People.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Devaganga. Language yes, used by ordinary people was?
Prakrit.
Prakrit. Ayan.
Yes, ma'am.
Language used by ordinary people.
Prakrit.
Prakrit was the language used by ordinary people. Okay. Then manuscripts were written in three languages, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Namasya.
Yes, ma'am.
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 Hello, ma'am.
Video, ma'am.
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 Video.
Video stuck.
Power failure.
Ma'am.
Ma'am, keep.
Ma'am, your microphone is muted.
Ma'am, your microphone
is muted.
Noted.
Muted.
We were talking about manuscripts. Manuscripts were written in
three languages.
Sanskrit,
Tamil, and
Prakrit.
It was used by upper caste people in early period. So Prakrit was the language of ordinary people.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
And Sanskrit was used by higher caste people, Brahmins, and all. They use Sanskrit. Normal people use, ordinary people use. That's why manuscripts were, inscriptions also written in this Prakrit language. Then only common people could be able to read. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Then, next question is, person who learned about the, or those who study the objects.
Archaeologist. power failure again.
Power failure again. मैम चली गई.
Who's the host? Harriet is the host. Harriet is the host.
Harriet is the host.
Ayush, Andrini Vijo, Ananda Krishnan, your video is not on.
Good evening, sir.
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 Good evening. Not yet 4 o'clock, maybe. What do you have now? Geography?
Politics.
History.
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 It is finished today.
Yes, ma'am.
What did you have?
Revision for exam.
Revision.
Which subject you had today?
Second language.
B. Second language.
Second language.
What lesson are you taking now? Topic for revision.
What, where, how, and when?
What,
where,
what, where, how, and when?
How, and when?
How, and when?
What? For how, and
where, when, how?
Good afternoon, sir.
What is the topic for what, where, how?
Sir, about the past.
About the past.
Yeah.
History.
Yes,
yes, sir. Is it Indian history or world history?
Indian.
Indian history.
Yes, sir.
Which period are you learning now of Indian history?
Social science.
Social science, I know. But you are saying Indian history. Are you learning about some dynasties? Some
sources of history.
Pardon?
So we are learning about sources of history.
Social studies, what is history? Sources of history. Sources. What are the sources? Who can tell me?
Theology, inscriptions.
Theology.
Inscription. Archaeology.
Okay. Bye. Emil Lijo, what is the spelling of geology? Unmute.
Sir?
Spelling of geology.
Geology.
G-E-O. Spelling of geology.
G-E-O. L.
Geology. G-E-O. No idea. Devika, what is the spelling of geology? Devika, unmute and tell me spelling,
sir,
of spelling of geology.
G-E-O. L-O.
Hello?
G-Y.
G-Y. Very good. Shravana, what is the meaning of geology? Shravana, what do you mean by the term geology? What do you learn in geology? Tell me, Shravana. Unmute and tell me.
Sir, they are not learning about geology in this lesson.
What is the meaning of the word geology?
I don't know, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
You don't know. Who knows?
Sir.
Yes, tell me.
About Earth and solar system.
Earth and solar system, both.
Now, the lesson is Earth and the solar system and geology is studying about Earth.
About the Earth, very good. Very good.
Thank
you. Geology, then what else did you say?
Manuscripts and inscriptions.
What is manuscript?
Sir,
spelling of manuscript.
Excuse me, sir.
Francis
this
Richard.
Chapter, they are not studying about geology. They are studying about archaeology.
Archaeology?
Yes, not yes, theology.
But then,
the
why did you say geology? What is archaeology?
Sir, I told archaeology.
Studying of the...
So I'm sorry, I misheard it. Okay.
Okay.
What is spelling of archaeology?
A-R-C-H-A-O-L-O-G-Y.
And what is the meaning of archaeology?
Studying of the remains of the
past.
Okay, archaeology. Then what else?
Manuscript.
What is the meaning of manuscript?
Sir, handwritten.
Handwritten. Where all did they do the writing?
In
Park of Birch Tree.
What is the meaning of bark?
Sir, the skin of the tree.
You call skin the outer layer. Okay. Carry on. Ma'am is there waiting. Sorry.
Thank you, sir. Then we discussed about archaeology, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Those who study about the objects of past are called, are known as?
Archaeologists.
Study about the remains of past or the objects of past are called archaeologists. Then, okay, I think we have covered almost all topics from this lesson, right?
Yes, ma'am.
How to remember under this, in this lesson we have focused four elements. What, where, how, and when. Last one is when means it's related with the date, right? Here you have to learn about BC. What is the full form of BC?
Before Christ.
Yeah, all days before the birth of Christ are counted in BC. Right? That's why when you see, when you read history textbook, you can see years are marked in BC.
BC.
In this lesson, we are focusing on four elements: what, where, how, and when. Right. Under the heading "what," we are trying to find out answer for all the questions: what people ate in the past, what type of clothes they, or what kind of clothes they used, what games children played, like that. Many questions we have. We are trying to find out answer for all the questions: what they did in early period, right? What earlier people did about their lifestyle and all about their food habits, right? What was their lifestyle? We are trying to find out answer for all these questions. And our historians and archaeologists are doing the same, right? They are trying to find about past lifestyle of people in the past, right? Then next, under the heading, where did people live?
lived.
Some people lived on the banks of River Narmada. Some people lived on Garo Hills and Sulaiman Hills. Then what people did? And people engaged in different occupations here. Then next we discuss why did people travel from one place to another, or we can say how was traveling was an important point of important part of life, right? How was traveling an important part of life of the people in the past? Or why did people travel from one place to another? There are many reasons for the right. We have discussed all the points, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Have written the same in your notebook, I think, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Then name of the land. The word India comes from
Indus.
River Indus.
Right. Then three sources. Right? Or how did we get information? There are several ways of finding about the past. One is manuscripts, manuscripts and historians and archaeologists are like dictated because they are using all the sources, like all the sources as clue to find out past, for finding out the past. So they are like dictators. I hope it's clear, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
It's the time to wind up the class. It's the Saturday you have PT test. Social science, you have to prepare two lessons. One more lesson is it from geography, the earth in the solar system. Right? We have done it, right? If you have a, when you read the textbook, you should read your textbook. Be thorough with that. When you read the textbook, if you have any doubt, you can contact.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. I don't have the textbook.
Okay, ma'am.
Download it.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Try to get textbook.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.